Installing NovaBot on Telegram will help you trade meme coins faster on PumpFun. Because PumpFun tokens move so fast, it's pretty much a must-have Telegram bot to execute trades on top of high volume. You can trade any crypto token with NovaBot, but the sniper feature is most useful on PumpFun because it allows you to automatically buy and sell after Radium migration. To start, take the early access NovaBot link from the description and paste it into your browser. That will take you to the NovaBot inside of Telegram. Click the start button, and if it's your first time using Nova, you will be prompted to save your private key. You can access your private key from wallets as well anytime. If you don't see this menu, then type /menu to open up the main menu. The first button is buy. To buy a token, you simply click on the buy button, and then it asks for the token address. So you're just gonna copy and paste down your token's contract address. This is a PumpFun token that has not been bonded yet, and hit enter, and it'll pull up the information on the token along with the pre-filled amounts for options to buy. And if you want to enter in a custom amount of SOL to purchase with, then you would just click the X SOL button. This shows the wallet that you are going to make the purchase with, or you can set a limit order. And this is the sniper that I was talking about, where you can automatically buy or sell the token after migration. We'll talk more about that later. Down here is the MEV protection and your slippage setting. Basically, the MEV protection is green, so that's on, or you can change it. You just click on it and that will turn it off. And it says processor node. There's processor node and processor ultra. Basically, that just means that the transaction is going to go through super quick, except there's the possibility that you might get MEV'd, which basically means you're open to sandwich attacks and front running. So it's better to leave this on, especially if you're buying and selling with large amounts of SOL. Slippage, 20% is okay, but you might want to play with this. If you get failed transactions, you might want to raise the slippage, especially if there's high volume trading on a certain coin. So for this example, I'm just going to purchase 0.5 SOL of this coin. All right, now if I go up to the token information, I can see that I have a balance of 17.7 million, and that's worth roughly 0.51 SOL. Okay, and let's close this and go back to the main menu. The next button is positions. Just left click on positions to see your positions. And you can see that we have one position. To go into the buy and trade options for the tokens that you hold, they would be listed here and you would just click on them. So that's positions. Go to the bottom and let's go back to the main menu. The next button is wallets. Left click on wallets. This is where you can manage your wallets. At the top will show you your current wallets. And then there's also the option to create wallet, import your wallet, delete wallet, rename wallet, and you can withdraw SOL as well as export your private key. So importing a wallet would be a good idea if you want to use the same wallet with your Bullex and your NovaBot. I show you how to export your private key from Bullex to import here. To see that video, check the link in the description. This is wallets. Now let's go back to the main menu. Next we have limit orders. Left click on the limit orders button. As you can see, I have no active limit orders. To set the limit orders, you would just click on the positions button and then click on the token, and that will give you the options to set the limit orders. Click back to main menu, and here we have the copy trade button. Left click on it. So I have no copy trade set up, but in order to start a copy trade, you would just click start new task and then enter in the wallet address of the person that you want to copy trade. Once you have entered in that task, you can click the start all and then the stop all once you're done copy trading. Let's go back to the main menu now. And the best option I have saved for last, that is the sniper. Let's left click on the sniper now. This is where you can see your active sniper tasks. I don't have any set up, so let's set one up. We'll go back to the main menu and then go to positions. And here is that token that I purchased earlier. So let's left click on it. And since I have already purchased this token and it has not bonded yet, we get the option to auto sell when bonded. So let's left click on that and just make sure that you are still in sell mode. And for the sell amount, after this token bonds, if it bonds, we're going to choose to automatically sell 100% of our position. And just to make sure that we get out, I have my sell slippage set to 100%. and the selfies are 0.005 with the same in the tip. This is actually kind of low, but I'm not trading with a large amount. Previously, we purchased half a soul worth, and so I don't want to be using a $10 or $20 fee just to sell half a soul. MEV protection will keep on, but if you experience any issues with the speed of the automatic sell, you'll probably want to turn this off because MEV protection does add a little bit of processing time to the sell. And if we look up at the status, we can see that this operation is stopped or inactive. So we just want to turn on the sniper task to sell after bonding. So we need to left click on stopped, and that will change it to running. So now we have this task that is running in the background, waiting for our token to bond. And once it does, it's going to sell 100% of our position. Go back to tasks, and we have confirmation here again that the task is running. This is to snipe sell a token after migration, which is a standard practice to collect initials, lessen exposure, or just get rid of a token that you think will dump immediately after the migration. But you can also snipe buy a token on PumpFun after migration as well. Snipe buying a meme coin during its migration period is a popular option too, because oftentimes a coin will bond too quickly for you to get in. As previously mentioned, it would be ideal to use the same wallet in NovaBot as Bullix, so that when you buy in NovaBot, you can see your positions instantly in Bullix. To see how to export your wallet from Bullix to NovaBot, check out the next video, which is linked in the description.